Welcome to Dividends Friday, and this Friday I have a very special guest to talk about this dividend stock. It is Miss Guinea Pig, and you can see she's looking very, very excited to be on screen. Say hi to everyone.
Hello everybody.
How are you feeling today?
I'm having a little bit of cough.
Yes, and today our topic will be talking about pets medicine. So this is a very interesting topic. Now you go and eat your grass, okay? Okay. So this is the stocks we are talking about, which is PetMed Express. Now this company is very, very interesting because when I look into it, my guinea pig, right? I've been seeing ever since my family bought this guinea pig, we've been buying a lot of like supplies and a lot of food, a lot of things for these pets. And let me share with you that this company, this is the website, how it looks like. It's called PetMed, which is Pets Medicine Express. It's America's largest pet pharmacy. Just to share a little bit, I did a bit of research and realized that if you look at the pets medication industry, it is growing heavily. And let me show some of the statistics. This report is from 2015, but some of the information here is still very relevant. Okay, let's look at the general facts and trends, okay, which is on page 7. Let me zoom into here because personally, I'm not really a pets person. If you like pets, you can comment below in the video. You can see that right now in US, about 65% of the US households own pets, and they treat pets like one of their own family members. You can see here the attitude towards pets, okay, increasing number of Americans have come to think of their pets as a member of their family. And when I speak to like my friends or even Mary Buffett, she has her dogs, and you can see that sometimes when I'm calling her, she'll be bringing her dog to see the vet, or like putting a lot of care and attention on the dogs and in their pets. So for me, it's hamsters and guinea pigs. Now coming back to here, so it's a growing industry, and this particular company, they provide medicine, or it's a pet pharmacy online. It's like an Amazon for the pet industry, where you can buy things online. We will talk a little bit more about their competition and things like that, but let's look at their finances. You can see that right now, the dividend is about 4.79, P ratio 11.22. So it is pretty fairly priced, I would say. Going into here, their finances, let's look at the revenue. Pretty flat and increasing bit by bit, as you can see. So from 200 over million, increasing to 286 million. Not a drastic increase, but steady. Sometimes slow and steady wins the race, correct? So you heard about the rabbit, correct? I always feel that it's not a realistic story, but anyway, let's understand the principles of it. Earnings per share also slowly increasing over the years. Again, not a huge spike in growth, but generally doing well. Dividends. Nice payout of dividends. They have been paying out increasing dividends every single year for the past 8 to 9 years. So that's why this is one of the possible dividend stocks. Very under radar. Not many people has talked about this stock. As I try to research more about this stock, not much information about it. But you can see, based on their finances, doing pretty well. Okay, shares. One part that I never really talk about much. You can see shares outstanding has been decreasing, meaning to say they have been buying back their shares. So what it means for us investors, right, shareholders, if you are existing shareholders and the shares reduces in the market, when the company buys back more shares, we are owning a bigger percentage of the company without doing a lot more. So let's look at one thing that I always have been emphasizing recently is the net margin. Net margin, 10% over, drop down and then increasing to 14%. Fluctuates, but you can see on average, based on your eyeball looking, is about 10%. If you cannot see, time to take some medicine. But not the pets one, of course. And overall, I would say that this company pretty efficient. Return on equity 30% over. Okay, fluctuates also. You can see there's a few dip in these years, but increasing again. Now, interesting portion, interest coverage. You see a dash here. What does it mean? Let's counter check. Debt to equity is also a dash. Does this mean that there's no debt? Let's take a look. Okay. I have zoomed in into the balance sheet of PetMed, and I try to find what is the amount of long-term debt. I couldn't see any figures here. So very likely, as I dig further, I realized they don't really have much debt. Now let me show you what does a general company looks like when they have debt. Okay, for example, this company, B&G Food, which I'll talk a bit about later. Okay, you can see that in the balance sheet, there's this thing called long-term debt. Okay, which is $1 billion in long-term debt. Okay, you can see for PetMed, no long-term debt. So overall, very very clean in terms of no having no debt. Cash flow is stable. So quite an interesting company. Again, not much under radar. If you take a look at the website, very very clean and very obvious of what they are doing. You can buy medicine here, and they even have a consultation. Like you can ask the vet. So for example, I have keyed my information and ask about if my guinea pig is suffering hair loss. Is it suffering hair loss? Mm. It is, okay. So what medicine can I give? And I already submitted and see whether they will answer my email. They replied saying that they will answer within 24 hours. So this is one of the additional function they give. Now, the thing is this, when I search for other possible competitors, I found this other company called PetCares. Look at the website, they're selling like NexGard or HeartGard for dogs. It looks similar and exactly the same as PetMeds. So I do not really understand what is the key competitive advantage. Why should I buy from this website, PetMeds? Okay, I can see that there's a 30% discount, and this PetCares is only 25% discount. So what I think a possible advantage of PetMeds versus, let's say, other competitors is the size, because they're the largest pet pharmacy based on revenue, based on their reach, right? This is a potential advantage that they possibly can buy like all this medicine at a cheaper rate. And this is shown in their net margin, correct? Their net margin we have seen is about near 10%, which is very decent. Okay, in my opinion, it's very, very decent. So this is what I think. And one thing good is there is not a lot of huge costs, because it's mainly online, like Amazon. So overall, I think that this company is something that's quite interesting, and that's why I'm sharing this this Friday. Now, because I have a bit more time, right, I want to share with you some other interesting things that I have been searching into. Because initially, I was deciding between PetMeds, PetMed Express, okay, or this B&G Foods. Now, B&G Food, right, I want to share with you my train of thoughts because we have some time. So B&G Food, you can see this is the company. When I look into this particular company, let me see. Okay, I was actually interested in this company because the dividend yield is about 7.62%. Digging a bit further, what does it do? It actually distributes food. Okay, it's a food manufacturing company, and it has quite a number of brands. Okay, so let's take a look at some of the brands, like baking brands, condiment dressing, household brands, seasoning, snacks. Now, I want to share with you something. I've never seen all these brands before. When I dig in a bit further, it's mainly serving in the US. So is this company something that we may want to invest in? In fact, I was quite interested because food to me is something that is non-cyclical. Even if the financial crisis comes, these are things that we need. The revenue, you can see, has been increasing. Looks beautiful, correct? It's a much faster growing company, from 5 million to 1.7 billion in terms of revenue. Earnings per share also increasing. Dividends also increasing for many, many years. Now, let me show you the discomfort that I have. Why I did not share this company and instead I choose PetMed. Because here is the portion, payout ratio. You can see that the earnings per share, they are making like 44 cents, 67 cents, but they're paying out 68 cents in terms of dividends. So are they able to sustain paying out such dividends? Let me show you something interesting, okay? Follow me here. Can you see the free cash flow per share? Okay, this shows us, this company, how much cash flow it has. After minusing, you can see the operating cash flow. Operating cash flow is here, which is after you minus away the capital spending, you get a free cash flow. In other words, as a company running, or rather, we have this company that's running this B&G Food, this is the amount of cash that we can extract from the company and still allow them to continue to operate. So this entire free cash flow, you can see, is very stable over the years, except for this year it dropped. But free cash flow per share, let's say, example, taking a look at 2009, $1.31 free cash flow per share. It is more than enough to pay out 0.68 in dividends. So in terms of dividends per share versus free cash flow, we have more than enough cash to pay out the dividends. But the question I have is this: Why is it making 40 cents, but it has free cash flow of 1.31? Very interesting. As you see, the years goes along, right? Same thing. The earnings per share is like 0.98, you can see. EPS, 0.98. So every share makes us 0.98 in terms of profit this year. But the free cash flow is 1.98. So where did the additional free cash flow come from? So the initial thought is very likely they have a lot of non-cash expenses. Okay, what's non-cash expenses? For example, depreciation, for example, amortization, where they buy like a huge like warehouse, or maybe like they build factories and they actually expense off the factories. So meaning to say the earnings per share, the profit is affected, but actually there's not much free cash flow. I mean, there's not much cash flow going out. So therefore, there's a lot of cash to give out in dividends. So I dig in a bit further. What exactly does this company do? Like I mentioned, there's a lot of brands. I think there's like 50 of our brands they mentioned. Now, this company, right, they do a lot of acquisition, buying out brands that people do not know. So where do I get all this information from? I read up a lot. I read up on Seeking Alpha, which if I want to read more, they have to pay for article. But doesn't matter. When I read more about this company, right, they actually buy a lot of other brands and they sell brands. So they buy and sell brands, which is something that I can share with you I'm not very comfortable with. I rather have a company that don't have to keep buying and selling. They have some very strong brands they themselves produce that makes them a lot of cash. So that's where a lot of the free cash flow comes in. As I dig in further and further, you can see that I'm reading a lot about this company. I'm reading their financial report. I was looking at what are the opinions. Anyway, when I read about these opinions, right, I'm digging out more for facts that I cannot really find just by purely reading the financial report. I want to see their latest movement. And let me share with you, after a while, I pause and tell myself, this company basically is too complicated for me. Am I saying that it's a bad company? Answer is no. But if I have to dig in so much furthermore to understand a company, right, I want to share with you, there may be opportunities that people are missing out. Because as I dig in more, I may find information that helps me form a better opinion. But at the same time, it may be possible that I may be confused and become paralyzed with information, or maybe I sort of like want to become like prove myself to be right that, oh, this company may be a good company to invest in. So I may find information to prove my point, or maybe this rather refute my point. So I just want to share that why in the end I do not share about this company as one of my so-called dividend pick of this week is because it's too complicated for me. So once it's too complicated, yes, I will dig in a bit further. I think that I'll be enjoying reading some of the annual reports for the next few weeks, but it's not something I'll invest in. So same thing, I just want to share with you guys, if something is too complicated, don't force yourself to read into things that you think is going to satisfy your own ego, okay? So rather keep something simple. PetMed is my choice this week, and I hope that this is something that benefits you as I share with you my train of thoughts, okay? So anyway, if you have any pets at home, make sure that they are healthy, and I don't know, man, it's like you can actually give it your comments on will you bring your pets. Okay, so let's bring our guests back onto the scene. Okay, you got any comments? What do you think of the recommendation this week?
Oh, I think it's something that I will buy for my children and my lifespan is...
How long is the lifespan?
6-7 years. About 6-7 years. So this company should be able to last until I pass on the stocks to my next children. Okay, that's all for Dividends Friday. Goodbye.
Wave goodbye.